الحمد لله رب العالمين أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده ولي الصالحين وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه وحبيبه وبعد. The story of the siege of the Sahaba with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. It is a fact. How can we relate it to our daily life? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us, we as Muslims, we have been preferred to any other nation because we كنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس تأمرون بالمعروف وتنهون عن المنكر وتؤمنون بالله. You have become the best of nations. Why? You enjoin what is good, you forbid the evil, and you are believers in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling us, من رأى منكم منكرا فليغيره بيده. Whoever of you sees or spots an evil going on, he or she, they have to change with their hands. فمن لم يستطع فبلسانه. Whoever cannot change with the hand, they should go with the speech, with the tongue. Speak against it. فمن لم يستطع فبقلبه. Whoever cannot even speak, change it in your heart. وذلك أضعف الإيمان. This is the weakest point of Iman. What is going on nowadays? Most of the Muslim countries and Muslim brothers and sisters are under the siege. We remember, as many of us may have forgotten, Gaza, Palestine. This is our major question as Muslims. This is the holy haram for us as Muslims. But living here in a convenient environment, relaxing, working, having a car, having a house, even if I am Palestinian, sometimes I forget about the Palestinian people. And I forget about Gaza. What you do not even know, that 30 Muslims were killed. Starting Al-Muharram, this Al-Muharram, we are 2 weeks in Al-Muharram now. 30 Muslims died in Gaza and nobody knows about it. Who controls the media? The powerful. The powerful, when they want to tell you something, they tell it to you. And if you discover a story, they tell you the story and the side of the story that will negate everything you may see or hear. So we have a siege in Gaza. And nowadays, what's going on? We have a siege in Kashmir. All of us, we can see this in the media. Our brothers and sisters are under the siege. And the siege of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the kuffar, they were humans. And they gave the Prophet and the Sahaba chance to go out and look for food and do this. And even some of them snuck some food inside the camp to the Prophet and the Sahaba, non-Muslims, kuffar. But nowadays the siege in Kashmir is a very tough one. And many brothers and sisters in that siege, they may lose their faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because they are challenged to negate the belief in Allah and to negate the belief in Muhammad, then they will be right. And they go through all these things. And we may not know about them. And if we don't know about them, it is our responsibility and Allah is going to ask us about them. There is no excuse of ignorance nowadays. Technology and social media is everywhere. We watch everything we want, but when we come to these things, Kashmiri, Gaza, we just scroll, we just scan, we don't delve into, we don't read, we don't respond. Why? Because it's against ourselves. It's against the comfortable environment I live to. Why I give myself a hard time even thinking about Muslims? If I don't think about Muslims, I am not one of them. That's what Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us. مَنْ لَمْ يَهْتَمَّ بِأَمْرِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ فَلَيْسَ مِنْهُمْ. Whoever doesn't take the affairs of the Muslims seriously and gets interested into the Muslims' affairs, he is not one of them. Look at the Muslims in China, what is going on? You go, brothers and sisters, under the siege. They take to separate the men from women, and they even get the women under kafir authority, and they sleep with them, and they rape them, and nobody speaks. And when you see the countries and the authorities and the governments, everybody is scared to speak because they will lose their offices. But me and you, we are regular people. What we are going to use? Nothing. But we still are cowards. We don't speak. We don't follow Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We don't rebel that evil with even dua. With even dua, wallahi, brothers and sisters. And sometimes some people, when they speak about these questions of Palestine, Kashmir, you go, even some masajid, they say, don't speak about this. We don't want to go to politics. This is not politics, wallahi. This is humanity. This is humanity. You can see here in Canada, people take care of the animals' rights. And we are living and leaving our brothers and sisters' rights. And they have rights on us. On the day of Yom Al-Qiyamah, they will stop us. The Kashmiri brothers and sisters, the Uyghur brothers and sisters, the Gazan brothers and sisters, all brothers and sisters around the world who are oppressed, going through the siege, they will stop me and you on the day of Yom Al-Qiyamah. And we will be asking, what did you do for them? What did you sacrifice for them? You didn't want to leave your comfort zone, even to make dua for them. If you can help physically, you help. If you can help financially, you help. If you have authority, you have to use it, because it is gonna be used against you soon. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make you an ayah. Me an ayah, me and you an ayah. If we reject the call of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if we reject the main reason because of which we are the best ummah, al-amr bil-ma'roof wal-nahi an al-munkar, if we don't do it, if we don't say it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may nullify all of our a'mal. Our hajj, our salah, our zakah, our siyam may not have any value with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when we are negligent about our Muslim brothers and sisters. We are not giving them help, we are not supporting him, when we are not even making dua for them. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, today it is a Friday, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala helps all Muslims who are under the siege. We ask him subhanahu wa ta'ala to help all Muslims who are oppressed. We ask him subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us. We are short, we cannot do anything. We ask him subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us to support them inshallah bi'idhnillah. We ask him subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive what we do from bad and to accept what we do from good. اللهم اغفر لنا ما قدمنا وما أخرنا ما أسررنا وما أعلنا ما أنت أعلم به منا أنت المقدم وأنت المؤخر وأنت على كل شيء قدير صلى الله على سيدنا محمد النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم وجزاكم الله خيرا
السلام عليكم Our shirt is very important topic today. That's why I'm here as well. Sheikh already explained everybody in English. I just want to explain it in Urdu as well. Inshallah, आज हम यहाँ पे जमा हो रहे हैं Medical Community Center. We are gathering at Medical Community Center just because of our brother and sister stuck. हमारे भाई बहन जो stuck हुए हैं कश्मीर में इस और fast 47 days से वो stuck हुए हैं कर्फ्यू में. हमारे बूढ़े बच्चे जवान मारे जा रहे हैं. औरतों के साथ ज्यादतियाँ हो रही हैं, लड़कियों के साथ ज्यादतियाँ हो रही हैं. 80 लाख लोग वहाँ पे कर्फ्यू में हैं पिछले 47 दिनों से. 47 days now. कश्मीर are locked down last 47 days. For 80, almost 80 lakh people, 8 million people are stuck there. So please, brother, we need to raise our voice. So we are just gathering here tonight, 7 o'clock, Medwell Community Center, today. Just close to your home. Just cross the street from here. Whatever we can do, brother and sister, jo bhi hamare, inshallah, hamare jo boundary mein hai, jo hum kar sakte hain, we must do it, inshallah. So we are gathering here, inshallah. So please, everybody are invited to come here and show your solidarity to our brother and sister, inshallah. See you, inshallah.